Hello, everybody. I think I'm ready to roll. We're live here from my house. This is Roya, Pilates, group exercise, you name it, instructor at the Claremont Club. So we're going to do a nice athletic bar version today using the chair. I promise the chair is coming back. So today we're going to use that chair, some light weights if you have them, and also a can. We're going to do a little bit more actual bar work. That's why I want the chair, so that you can have a little bit more support when you do the standing work. And lots of floor work, lots of everything. I'm going to give you about a minute or two. Let me check my volume on my iPad. Oh, I'm glad I did that. All right, I think that's much better. And then I'll get started. So happy, what day is today? Thursday. Quarantine 2020. Let's do it. Oh, one more. I keep forgetting this. Time to roll. Thank you, Erin. So let's start standing. Take a big breath in and bring your arms up. Exhale as you inhale. Do that one more time. Exhale, this time reach all the way out and over, extending from those shoulders. Actually, from those sit bones, extending out, round that lower back. And then big reach out. So you're trying to straighten those legs as much as possible, placing the weight into the balls of your feet. One more time, round that back. And then reach all the way out, dropping that chin, relax all the way down. Take a mini breath in, bend those knees. Exhale deeper as you press straight. One more time, bend those knees. On your exhale, you deepen that stretch, straightening those legs. Hold there for a minute. Take both hands with your feet parallel to one side, and then to the other side. Place one foot forward, other leg back. Weight is on the inside of your front knee. You're going to reach and rotate to the sky or the ceiling. Place that hand back down. Try to straighten both legs. If you can't keep your hands on the ground, place them up at the top. Hold it here. We'll switch to the other side. Dropping low into the inside of that other leg. Rock forward and back a little, making sure you're getting that inner thigh in the front stretch, hip flexor in the back. Reach up. Place that hand back down. Go ahead and pull that back foot underneath you. Drop that back heel. Drop the hand. Hold it here for a second. Deepen that stretch. Make sure that front leg is straight. Open both legs, drop low into those knees, pushing those knees back. Straighten the legs once more time. One hand around the ankle, reaching to the ceiling. Other way. Come back to center and just roll up one vertebra at a time, stacking that spine, dropping down. Let's warm it up with some planks. And I did say you need some light weights, right? So hopefully everybody has some light weights near them. And also a can. I'll give you that cue later. You can always grab it. You're going to go onto your elbows. And we're going to hold that long line plank. Your body is pressing that floor away with those shoulder blades. Dropping one knee. Your right leg up, open and close, open and close. Immediately starting to engage that outer glute, even inner thighs to draw that leg back. Two more. We go to the other side. That leg lifts and you pull it open. open and close. Push that floor away from you. You come back to center. You rock forward. Forward and back. Give yourself that nice extension from those shoulders. Slowly, you're going to drop the hips. Drop the hips. One direction first. Let's go four more. Other side. Really twist from that waist. We're gonna go three more eights. Drop right, drop left, drop right. Keep pushing that floor away. If you have to stay on your knees, go for it. Otherwise, we drop and lift, lift. We've got four. Press harder into those shoulders. Make sure that upper back is flat and there's no rocking in that lower back. Press forward and back. Forward, back. And relax. You're gonna come up onto your side. You're gonna have a hand down and we're gonna start lifting just one leg. Lift. So that hand is down. I'm at an angle here. So you lift your torso to that foot, and that foot can come slightly in front of you. Now both legs are gonna lift. I don't know if you feel this from the other day, but I do. Come on up, everybody. Obliques, your quadratus, lift, and rest. Don't worry, we'll do side planks too. But right now we're starting with this. Hand is down. We just lift that leg. Lift that leg. So it's coming slightly forward and up. Four, three, two. You're staying up now with both legs. Lift. Torso coming to legs. Those legs have to pull slightly forward. Eight, seven. Keep going. Four, three, two, and relax. All right, we start with our glute series. So grab some kind of weight that you can place behind your knee. And again, you worked out a little harder the other day, you don't want to put the weight there, keep it out. We're gonna get stronger by the time we get back. Let's go. Flex that foot and lift. It's slower. I want you to focus on the muscles that are working right now. And I think you should know what it is. Those hamstrings and glutes. Let's make it a little bigger. Control through that core. Tighten those abs. Push that floor away from you. Do not forget about that upper body just because you're focusing on legs. Bigger. Come on. Bigger. Now I'm giving you that full range of motion. So still isolating right here. You're gonna pull that knee forward. Forward, forward. Trying to pull it all the way up to that shoulder. And notice that knee is high, keep it high. Let's go for some circles. Up. Take that knee, cross it across that body, inward, up, in and across. You're pushing that floor away from you, everybody. You're crossing that knee in. We're going back up to the top. Most of our straight leg work will be with the chair today. So right now, let's focus a little higher on that glute, a little more hamstring. Hold on. Knee forward and back. It's small. You're focusing. on that range of motion within that hip joint. But you're keeping that knee high. Come on. Up. You don't see me again till Saturday. So let's do this. Come on. Well, I guess you could if you want to watch the videos. Go for them. Out and in one more time. Hold on tight, hold on tight, hold on. Ouch. Sit back onto your heels. Stretch it out. Drop into that hip that just worked. So really drop yourself into that hip. Just get a nice little stretch. And we will repeat that exact same thing.
Maybe. If I can find the playlist.
Alright. Other leg. And if you were using a weight, if you were using something behind there, I think you noticed that we did not remove it this time. So, let's repeat that on the other side. You're holding up. Up. Squeeze, guys. Remember, your movement is coming from here and opening through that hip. Not rocking in the back, no swing. Very small movement. Pushing that floor away from you. The movement's gonna get a little bigger. Just control tighter. Two more eights, I need an even bigger. Right here. In and up. You're gonna pull that knee forward. 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 Remember, you're trying to get that knee to that elbow or shoulder. But that knee needs to stay lifted. We go up. Tighten it up, everybody. Tighten it up. Squeeze tighter. Higher. Lower backs are not rocking. Here we go. We rotate inward. So from the front, I'm rotating inward. Down. Down. That knee is hidden in the crease of the other knee. Forward and back. How we doing? Forward, back, forward. We got some little circles there. Come on. They're small. They're controlled. They're high. Stay behind you high. Squeeze, guys. Squeeze tighter. Use that hamstring more. A little bigger. And relax. Take that weight out from under you. Extend those arms out. Once again, dropping into that hip. So you really want to kind of shift your body weight into that hip that was just working. And take your hands onto the opposite side. I'm going to do a little back extension. Any day that I do a lot of back work with the leg, I really want to get your back warmed up. So if you have a can, use it. I'm just going to use my weight. It rolls. I'm just going to put it under my hands. And then be ready to do a little bit more side work as well. So you're going to place those hands directly on that rolling device that you got in front of you. And we're going to pull. Separate those legs slightly with a slight lateral rotation. You're going to bring it in and lower. Left, lower. I am not cramming into my lower back. I am using my abdominals to keep my ribcage knitted. And I'm using my muscles on the sides of my spine to lift. Lift. Pull those abs in tight. A little more right. You're going to stay up a little higher and pulse it in for 8, 6, 4. You're going to come down. You're going to pulse just the right leg up for 8. Extend those fingers. Extend those toes. Other leg. 7. Pulling those arms in again for 8. Up. 7. Relax. I'm going to take one hand across your forehead. If you're not getting this height, don't worry about it. You're just going to try to focus on that waist and back area. As you lift your elbow to the ceiling and back simultaneously. Lift. You've got 4. Let's switch it to the other side. Pull it in. Got that. Up and rotate. Rotate. Take a second break. We're going to go a little quicker. Try to isolate these muscles. Huge area that we don't work quite enough. So we're going to isolate 8 to the right, 8 to the left. Forehead, elbows to the ceiling. Other leg, other way. Hands down, right leg. Straight, long, extended. Feel that glute and hamstring in the work. And then also those back muscles, abs tight. Chair. I mean, if you're inside and you have a bar top or something, that's absolutely fine as well. I'm just going to use my chair. Stand out. Stretch out. And let's open those knees once and just kind of drop down in between so you're feeling a little bit of an inner thigh stretch as well. Still in that lower back. Let the head hang. So you got that chair, and we're going to alternate doing some back work, some front work, some stuff we haven't quite done in a long time. So right now, I'm going to place both hands on that chair, and we're going to extend that leg to the back, tightening those abs. You're going to lift up and lower, so bring it all the way back, open. I want you to wake this up. You can lean forward, that's fine. Let's go the other leg. I'm just gonna stay facing this way. So pull that leg back. Notice I am leaning forward. It's gonna get a little more extension, it's okay. Four on the right, or left, either way. Other leg, 4 more. Be ready, we're gonna keep that leg a little higher. On the next set, that leg goes up and stays. Working out position, try to get that chest up towards that foot. Once again, that focus is all across that back side, including that glute. Stay. Anybody's got the power? They don't see it little higher, a little less movement. Come on, isolate. And rest. Other leg, other side. Set those shoulders down and back. Make sure you're not here. Forward a little is okay, but not tensing. Other leg, remember we got those 4-8s, quick. Let's do it. Look. Get a little smaller, you're gonna get a little higher, a little more isolated. One more eight, a little higher. Try to fight that chest lifting a little more against that foot. We're gonna take one hand on only and lift that right leg up. So I'm gonna lift it up at an angle. It's slightly bent. I want you to focus on some rotation. This is a series we have not done in a while. Up. You want to grab something, a can, a weight, do it. I got my tomatoes. Up, down. Other leg. So I'm just going to do it without holding on right now. Turn it out and notice it is bent. I want you to create that rotation with that hip. Rotate. A little too close to cover. Come on, let's go eight more. We are gonna speed this up. I need you to use that supporting glute. Give me a second. Okay, we go right leg quick and then left leg. So I'm putting this in the middle so I can use it because we're gonna be doing our some upper body work as well in between. Grab that chair and let's lift that leg up quicker. Here we go. We're up. Up. Again, that knee is rotated. Quick. Shoulders, legs, everything's working together. Abs are tight. Let's straighten that leg for 2-8. Straighten it. Chest is up. 8 more. Relax. So we have not been doing that. I don't know if you have anywhere, but I haven't. And I can always tell. So other leg, bent knee, bent elbow. Don't worry about so much pointed toes, all that. Just work your body together. 2, 3. Seven. Straight leg now. Tap it out. Nice and strong through that core, lift. Supporting leg is long. Relax a second. We're gonna do a full bent knee series to the back in a minute. I'm just moving my chair so you can see better. We're gonna go right into a set of tricep dips. Elbows facing directly back. Drop. Chest is lifted. Booties are back. Don't stop. If you have to, go for it. Otherwise, we go right leg lifts. But still pulls back. Other leg. One eight, super slow. Come on. Seven. Don't let those shoulders roll forward. Butt goes back. Rest. You're gonna lean back. I'm gonna do it where the chair back is not directly behind me, so I have a little bit more range of motion. So try that so that you don't have the chair back right behind you. Lifting your legs up. If you have to put one down, put it down. Lift. Lower. Lift. Lean. Pull. Lean. Flies. Don't fall off that chair. Hold on. Okay? We
that up. Can you extend those legs a little more? Up. Pull in, hollow out that lower back. Tip your knees one direction, torso goes the opposite direction of those knees. More waist, twist everybody. Other way. So I'm twisting the opposite direction of my knees.
Have gotten better, but now my music is having, I keep touching it or doing something. All right. Full push-up position. It's not, you can see what I'm doing. I'm sticking my butt out. That makes me work my chest less, so if you have to bring the knees in, do so. But otherwise, we're holding that long line and pressing. Pressing. Flatten those palms if you'd like. Push, guys. Anytime you need to stop, you stop. We're gonna hold for about 8 more. Bigger dip. Arm is framing your face.
everybody. Eight more. And rest. Feels a little balletic, but it's so functional and such great work down on that back. So go ahead and place your hands down on that chair. Press into it. Press into it. Round that back. Pull that belly button into your spine. Press out one more time. Round. Stretch it out. Ready? You didn't think we were done with push-ups, did you? Feet back. Push that floor. Shoulders set down and back. Elbows bend and open wide. Down. I do want those elbows to flare out. You already did triceps with those elbows in. Now open those elbows. Push deeper. You've got four. Come on, get stronger. And rest. Let's push that chair away for a little bit. Actually, you know what? Keep it near you. Let's go into a set of abs. So you can see my chair right here, right? Yes. I'm gonna place my hands behind me. You're gonna take your legs over that chair. Up to the right, up to the left, up. If you have to keep one leg down for right now, just to kind of get the feel of it, go for it. You're getting rotation, you're getting flexion, you're getting lots of abs. Depending on the height of your chair, it's gonna also depend on how hard you work. If you can bend your knees a little, let's do that that way. Give you a little bit of leeway. So bend and drop and lift, drop it over. And lift, drop it over, lift. All the way over, don't stop. Drop. Straighten, just bend and straighten. Don't touch that chair, bend, reach, bend. Bending to that chair, and then away, to it, away. All the way up and over, over and down, over and down. You adjust, you monitor. You need to bend those knees, you bend them. You can hold on, you hold on. More. Up and over. And over. And rest. Let's place our feet on that chair. I know it's a little high. Place them on there. You're going to lift your hips up. You're going to stay up. You're going to extend one leg. You're not going to lower too much. Try to keep your foot flat, the one that's on the chair. Stay high, hamstring, guys. My hips are high. I want one straight line from your knees to your shoulders. and then you only break a tiny bit, and squeeze. A lot of inner thighs, right leg up. Whoop. Other leg. All the way in. Rock side to side. Alright. Ready? We're gonna stand up. So let's move that chair away. Just let me love you when your heart is tight. We're gonna go into some curtsy squats. Grab a weight. And most of the time I'll be doing a little bit of those. But I'm going to make it a little bit of a change. If you have a weight that you can manage to do a side lateral raise, you're going to do that. You're going to drop. You're going to lift. You're dropping. You're lifting. I am crossing all the way over, leaning, opening out. Drop. And lift. Let's go quicker. Down. Up. Down. Up. Down. So I am not bringing that weight across my body. I'm keeping tension on that shoulder. Down. Keep going. Hold it down. That booty out more, lean forward. It's okay on this one. Come up and just arm out to the side. Up. Up. Isolate that shoulder, everybody. For four. And rest. Cross the other direction. We lift. Take it down, lift it up. Take it down, lift it up. You speed it up a little bit. Drop. Four, come on down. Back up and then reach the other way. Lean forward and go to the other side. Coming back up. All right, let's go into some biceps. I'm going to make it pretty simple. I'm going to do a side view. We have not done any straight leg front extension, so like I said, today a little bit more balletic. Just for that balance, some exercises we haven't done in a while, changing it up a bit. You are gonna curl, and you're gonna lift that other leg, the opposite leg forward. So very simple. Hold on one second. So abs are tight. You're isolating that bicep, keeping those shoulders down. Pulse to the top. Four, three, two, bottom end. Leg stays lifted. Top end. Bottom end. Can we do eight all the way through? Let's get my hands up and down. A little bit more extension. A little bit more range of motion. Four. Three. Two. And one. Other leg. Other arm. So we're going to go full. You're counting. Good for you. You got about 16. Another eight. You got about 32 repetitions right here. So let's go all the way through. Whoa, whoa. Did I mention balance? Up. Oh, you can just tap. Four more. Little ones at the top. Tap. Bottom. Again, top. So by top, I mean you're not going past 90 from top to bottom, and then only up to about 90 from bottom up, and then all the way through for your last eight. Seven. Three. Two. And one. Rest a second. So, open the arms. You're going to go into, again, I'm going to go onto your side, wide second position. From that second position, you're going to flip all the way around and go into a lunge. Notice my knees are both at 90. Coming back to that second with both feet wide. Glutes, inner thighs, quads, firing. Right? I'm going to do that quick. Let's do it. Use your arms. It gets your shoulders going to open. And down. How about just one arm? Rotate. Whoop. Full rotation, everybody. That waist here to here. Open. You stay in that lunge right here and down. Lower, yes, eight. Rest, we go the other way. So now, the other arm, come back to the other side, okay? So if you're mirroring me, you're probably gonna go, now you're gonna go left. So let's do it. Out, in, out, in, out. Strong shoulders, strong waist. Strong core, strong legs, eight more, down, cross, four, we lunge, we hold, drop, don't stop, nice and low, both legs 90 degrees, eight more deeper, tighter abs. Chest up higher. Three, two, and rest. You got it. Let's stretch it up. You need something to hold on to, grab it. Pull that foot up.
We are the fire. We are the spark. We are the ones who light the city up.
Other leg.
We are the sea.
You guys are all doing well. Feel like you're getting a full body workout. Let's start with a nice plank series. We got a big series here. And just so you know, I'm trying to give you a little bit of everything right now, this series. If you need to be on your elbows, you go ahead and go onto your elbows. You need to stop in between, you stop. You're gonna get your full body going for the next, well, the plank series about 4 minutes.
And then about another 4 minutes of that. And then we'll stretch. So I'm gonna make it a little dynamic in between. I'm gonna face forward and I'm gonna be on my hands. You're gonna rotate in, rotate out, tuck all the way in, straighten. You'll see it as we go. Pay attention to my cues. And I'm assuming you can all hear me, even when the music's on. Yes? All right, let's amp up for this. Make sure you're not slipping. Make sure you've got a good base for your feet. Enough space around you. And you grab some water somewhere in between this mess. We cross. In. We open. We tuck. Three. We tuck. Two. We tuck. One. We shoot it up for three. Two. One, we open and close for eight, seven, six, four. We cross the other way, in, open, take it in, two, three, we shoot it up, three, two, one, bring it in, jack, seven, six, four, three, and rest. How about we repeat that twice more? We are the fire. We are the star. Oh, I know what I want to add. Let's do one more set here. Come on in. In. Open. One tuck. One lift. Cross. Open. One tuck. One lift. One more time. Cross. Open. Tuck and lift. Come up onto your elbows. You're gonna pike those hips and drop. Pike, drop. I want you to feel your lats and triceps. So if you're looking from here, I'm pushing up, dropping into those elbows. Lats, shoulders, triceps. Come up under our hands. We jump for eight. Other leg crosses in, opens out, pulls in, high up, cross, open, in, lift, cross. Want you to feel is those triceps and shoulders. Push, pull, squeeze those armpits as you drop. More abs. Halfway, 16, here. Push, hips up. You're pushing from those shoulder joints. Eight more, yes. Four. And relax. All right, finish it off with some abs. You're gonna be lying straight down on your back. Place those hands behind your head. I hope you guys are sweating. Two. Hands behind that head, double tap. Your chest and shoulders are up. That floor. Head and shoulders stay up, hands. Legs come up, they beat down. Pressure on your lower back. Hands behind
that head. Bicycle. Chest and shoulders are off. Knees don't come past 90. Lower back is down. Rotate fully.
Closer. Bend your knee into your chest. I'm being very selective with my music, so that's why I keep changing it. And it's on shuffle again, figures. So, and no dog. I know that a lot of you are like, I like it when the dog comes, but guess he didn't make it out today. Bend that knee into your chest. Cross that knee all the way over. Bend that knee in. Roll that knee within that hip joint a couple times. And then reverse it. Reach the leg to the ceiling. Pull it in a little bit. Bend in again. Strain it, deepen that stretch. Other knee comes in. Cross it. Make sure the opposite arm is really wide. Bend it in. Roll that knee within that hip joint. Reverse. Lift that leg up. Bend it in. Deepen that stretch. Bend both knees. Open both knees. Bring your feet down to the floor. Let the knees just naturally, like gravity, open them up. Feel those inner thighs open. Go ahead and sit up. Look at number four in the front leg. And try to get up and over that hip a little bit. Cross your opposite arm over that knee, rotating and drawing that arm all the way down to the floor. And then cross that other leg over. Let's get that stretch into the back and the hips. Other leg comes forward. Other leg is back. Even if you don't get all the way up and over your hip, you're fine. Feel that stretch in that bottom side, glute, hip. Take that opposite arm, cross it over. Elongate it. So you're also getting the stretch across that back top waist. The leg that's extended wraps around, comes across the front. And twist. Bring both feet out in front of you.
lifting and extending one knee at a time. Rocking into that opposite side a little bit. And then lean all the way forward. Roll yourself up. Drop those shoulders down and back a couple times. Stack that spine, tighten those abs. And that's all for today. For Thursday, bar. I will be back on Saturday, but like I always say, all the live videos, all the other videos, everything that other of all of us instructors have done, they're all on the app and the Claremont Club Facebook page, so on and so forth. You got it. YouTube channel, thank you for joining us, staying active with us, and engaging with us. So happy Thursday. I will be back on Saturday with some surprises. What those are, I don't know yet. But I'll see you on Saturday, hopefully. And have a nice evening. Thank you. I love reading all these comments later. If I could just keep my face out of it, maybe I would. And then when people tell me later, they say, oh, I heard you snapping and it brought me back to the Pilates studio, all that kind of stuff. I love it. And I get texts of people that were live and just watching it later. So I appreciate it. Thank you. And we all from the club, so thank you for your support. Bye.